Big day because we are going to film 28 videos. Hey guys, welcome back to the channel where we are currently, of course, checking out lots of American Idol auditions. I saw on the American Idol YouTube channel this morning that they are coming to the end of this audition process. So that's really exciting. Then that's all done and then we can get into Hollywood Week and all the stress. Yo, I'm telling you what, I have pretty good control of my nerves after all these years, but I wouldn't want to go through that. I think it's really, really tough. Anyway, today we're going to look at Kaya Stewart and she's going to sing a song that she wrote together with her dad. And he is, of course, Dave Stewart, one of the members of Eurhythmics. I mean, he was abducted. They were abducted. Abducted? Inducted. Yes, he abducted these aliens. They were inducted into the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame and everything. I mean, huge band. Started in the 80s. And it was quite a moment when he walked into the room because him and Lionel Richie, you know, they are contemporaries and so on. But anyway, so they wrote this song called This Tattoo. And it's always, you know, when you bring in your own accompanist, and especially if it's for a reason like, oh, my dad is famous, then you almost just think, I really hope this singer is good, regardless of the fact that her dad is who he is, you know? Because it can feel or look initially like she's bringing him into to give her a better chance to go through instead of just on her own merit. But yeah, let's see what happened and then we'll talk about it.
Hi.
Hello.
Oh, wait, what? Say the backup musician is who?
Hi, everybody.
How are you?
I'm good. I'm Kaya. Nice to meet you guys. This is my dad.
I'm Dave. Nice to meet
you. Dave Stewart, who is accompanying me today.
Hi, Dad. How are you?
Oh, my God, blast from the past.
Oh, I'm loving this.
Music has been a part of my life since before I was even born. My dad was in a group called the Eurhythmics. When I was born, you know, my dad was on tour, and I was going to shows when I was still in my mom's tummy.
Plus, I'm going to tell you something. We were inducted into the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame together, and it was an evening that we will never forget.
It was amazing.
Thank you very much.
And just to have you with your daughter, I think is so cool.
I do too.
The musician's lifestyle has been something that's just been a part of my life. There was never a question of what I wanted to do with my life. It was just, that was always gonna be what I was gonna do.
With all the different opportunities and connections and stuff, how did you even land at American Idol if this is the right choice?
I mean, a huge part of me even coming on was getting to sing my own music, which is, I think that opened like a whole new world for me looking at American Idol.
I am singing a song today that my dad and I wrote together. I wouldn't want to do it any other way.
It's really a great feeling that this is now the creative destination for artists.
Totally.
American Idol is such a huge deal for me. I'm just really excited. I'm nervous, but I'm excited.
I've got choices that I make, and I'm not thinking about you when I make them. And if it's a mistake, then at least I know that I'm to blame. And so when I walk in that corner store, my heart this time won't hit the floor. Cause I don't care, I don't care if I let you go. A book on how to change, but I just can't get through the pages, and it's really such a shame. But I guess this time I've gotta say it. I'm not cold-hearted, just the truth. I guess I'm not in love with you, and I don't care. I don't care if I let you go.
Bit low.
And I
cool. I like her a lot. I like what the energy that comes from her, personality, the look. She's very comfortable with herself. Like in the package insert, you know, like what she said is she grew up with a dad who was a touring, international touring artist, and that whole lifestyle is just so familiar to her. And she said, I'm excited, but I'm nervous. But I think the nerves is probably not a big issue for her because I think she grew up on stages and around stages and stuff. It's like her home. So all of that, I think, is really cool. I also do enjoy listening to her voice because it's a very uncomplicated, straightforward sort of way of singing that she has. She makes a lovely, naturally beautiful sound. It's connected. It's under her control. It's actually a pretty light voice. Now, a lighter voice is the kind of voice that really shines in a higher register. And a darker voice naturally shines in a lower register. Excuse me. So she's got a pretty light voice. So I was quite surprised that this song was in A major, because that low A, which she sang a lot in the verses and at the end of the chorus, I mean, she sang it. It wasn't out of her control, but it's too low. I don't think vocally this is a brilliantly written song for her own voice, which is strange because when people write for their own voice, they normally, you know, stay away from outer limits and problem areas or things that aren't that comfortable for them or whatever. So if she did this whole song a whole tone higher, I think her voice would have shined. I don't know. I don't know if her voice can shone. I think it would have been better. Because when she did the high C sharp, it was really beautiful, open, powerful. Again, not a belt, just a very free, connected sound with a lot of airflow. But she could have done that easily, in my opinion, on a D sharp as well. And then the whole thing would have been lifted a little bit. Yeah, so I must say, I don't love the song. I think it's a cruisy sort of pop song. Of course, she knows what she's doing in terms of songwriting. It seems very organic and natural. And with the level of gifting that she has and her dad and all of that. So, you know, it's not a major criticism. I don't love the song. I don't think it was necessarily the best thing for her to sing to show off her vocal ability. But let's see what the judges said.
Thank you.
Can I get this tattoo? Yeah.
Thank you.
Dave, I have to tell you.
This is much more difficult than being inducted in the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame.
You know what? It's true. It's true, man.
It is.
This is more nerve-wracking than anything we've ever done in life.
It is.
Oh, my God. That was great.
Thank you so much. What do you think, Lionel? I mean, it's hard because he's like your brother.
We're in the same family.
Here. Be honest.
I'm going to tell you the truth because truth is what we are about. So, yeah. First of all, for the songwriting part and the pressure of being here, I give you so much props.
Thank you.
And the fact that your dad showed up, I give him props.
Yeah, right.
I mean, there's a whole lot of props here.
Yeah.
But in the midst of all of this, you slayed it. I mean,
thank you so much.
I love the tone of your voice, and you're an artist. You're really an artist.
Agree.
Thank you.
You know, this is a tricky competition, but I totally think you're worthy to go jump in the mix of all this. You know, you can tell that you've grown up on the stage, around the stage, and you've put in the stage presence side of it. I mean, you were comfortable and delivered it. Mm. Yeah, I thought it was great, and looking forward to potentially hearing some more stuff that you've written.
Ooh.
Thank you.
Look, I love that little flip in your voice.
Thank you.
I'm gonna get this tattoo removed when you flip into it. Can you do it one more time, just a cappella?
I'm gonna get this tattoo removed.
That's the sparkle stuff right there. The thing about us is we get really technical with it, and I'm sure,
like,
you know, we're gonna probably be a little bit more nitpicky with you because you're good, and also you understand it.
Yeah,
you know the business, and the business is real.
Let's vote.
Okay.
I am a yes.
All right.
Yes.
Hallelujah, yes.
Thank you so much. Thank you, guys.
You're going to Hollywood.
Everything you love about American Idol is right here. Subscribe now.
So I agree with what they said. Lionel said the songwriting props. Maybe we don't agree on that as much, but that's not important. I think she's so beautiful, everything about her. Nice gap in the front teeth, which is so beautiful. Yeah, she's authentic. She's real. She's just herself. And there is a sparkle there. And you know what's interesting? The flip that Katie was talking about. She does that flip without going to a breathy sound, which she probably can do if she wants to. But normally when people flip into that falsetto voice, which is a disconnected vocal folds, which is a bit of a breathy sound, mostly people do that. But she did a flip, but then even the high was a connected sound. So that's just another bit of proof for me that she really knows her own voice very well and has great control of it. So, yeah, good job. Happy for her. I hope she goes far. I think she doesn't have this massive voice, right? We have seen lots and lots of other people audition who have broader, better voices. Definitely people with bigger voices, bigger range, people who showed way more skill in their audition. But I think the whole package of her, you know, who Kaya Stewart is, the person, like Lionel also said, and like Luke said, you grew up on it, we can see that, you know, the stage presence, she's so comfortable. So I think that part of the competition is going to be so much easier for her than for many others. So I think she has a real chance to do well and to go far, and I wish her all the best. Thanks for checking out the video. Please like, share, please subscribe if you haven't already. And until next time, please take care of yourself. Before you go, let me just take an opportunity to remind you of my Patreon page, Charisma Performing Arts Patreon page. That's for people like you who are really serious about developing your voice, enhancing your ability to communicate more effectively using your voice, whether it's for speaking or singing. Patreon, check it out. The link is in the description.